Hallelujah. Hallelujah in the house. Why don't you rest upon your feet? Put your little hands up. He'll put his down. Hallelujah. Lord, we're here to magnify you. We're here to glorify the God of our salvation. We say yes to your will. Yes to your way. Yes, anyhow. Hallelujah, Lamb of God. We're here to say thank you. Come on, tell him thank you. Come on, tell him thank you. You brought us from a mighty long ways. Hallelujah. Amen, amen, amen. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. All that is within me. I will bless the Lord at all times. Can you say that? I will bless him at all times. When I don't feel like blessing him, I'm going to bless him anyhow. When things are going wrong, I will bless the Lord. When I don't see my way clear, that's not going to stop me from blessing the Lord. I will bless the Lord at all times. Shout all times. Holy God, we magnify you. We magnify you. Come on, magnify him. Somebody's getting a miracle right now as you praise him. I feel the healing virtue in the house. Oh, Holy One, Holy One, we magnify you and we glorify your righteous name. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Look at that person next to you and say, bless the Lord with me. Bless him with me. David said, bless the Lord with me. I don't want to bless him by myself. I want you to get in on the blessing. Oh, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. You got a lot on the inside. You got peace on the inside. You got joy, come on the inside. Come on, somebody. With everything that's on the inside, we owe him praise. Is there a witness in the house? Is there another witness in the house? Oh, glory. Hallelujah. How many know we serve a mighty God? Oh, come on, rest upon your feet. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. Oh, what a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. You know the angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. We serve a mighty God. A mighty God. We serve a mighty God. Oh, mighty God. We serve a mighty God. We serve a mighty God. Hey, what a mighty God we serve. Whoa, what an awesome God we serve. What an awesome God we serve. You know the angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. Thank you. Take your seat. Touching Jesus is all that matters tonight. And your life will never be the same. There's only one way, Holy One way you can touch Him. You must believe when you call on His name. Why don't you help me sing? Touching Jesus, let's touch Him tonight. So all that matters, and your life, my life, they will never be the same. There's only one way, same one way you can touch with. You must believe when you call on his name. Oh, touching Jesus, touching Jesus. That's all that matters tonight, church. Oh, Lord, your life, my life, your family life will never be the same. Oh, oh, there's only one way you can touch him. Yeah. You must believe. You must believe. You must believe when you call. His name, on his name, there's no other name like his name. Come on, tell him thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, magnify him with me. Praise God.
God is so good to us.
Who have let the problems of today lead them to conclusion, fact that life is not the way. But at yours you cannot find. Go talk it over. He'll give you peace of mind. If you live your life to heart, go and have a talk with God. Yeah. He's the only free physician known throughout the world, bringing peace to men and women, little boys and girls. If you live your life too hard, go and have a talk with God. Said many people who have let the problems of today lead them to conclusion, fact life is not the way. But every problem have an answer, yours you cannot find. Go and talk it over, he'll give you peace of mind. If you live your life hard, go and have a talk with God, yeah. Physician known throughout the world, bringing peace to men and women, little boys and girls. Live your life hard, go and have a talk with God. Live your life hard, go and have a talk with God.
witness preachers across America, get ready for a word from heaven. Wednesday night I get to preach, and hallelujah, I got this anointed prayer cloth. My dad had these prayer cloths in his office, and I had them printed, hallelujah, with his hand on it, my hand on it. I believe that we can stand together, hallelujah, and I believe in the power of prayer. So be with us on Wednesday night and Thursday night, Tommy Tenney. Hallelujah, if you love and your God Chasers, he wrote several books, God Chasers, you'll love Brother Tommy Tenney. Friday night, which is Dr. B, and then on Saturday morning, we will be giving out 30,000 books, hallelujah, free of charge. So make sure you're here at 10 o'clock to get some word. Get some word, and it's free on Saturday morning. If God's been good to you, shout hallelujah while Brother Welton Lane comes and get ready. Hallelujah, you're going to sing, preach up there, sing or preach down here. Hallelujah, where are you going? Hallelujah, we'll get you set up. We'll get you set up. We'll get you set up. Put your hands together for my little brother.
Praise God. Come on, let's give Jesus some more praise. Hallelujah. How many feel his presence in the house? Praise God. There's a couple of tracks. You can just start them at any time. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Time keep moving on through the sunshine and the storm. Till the sun shine again. For now, I'm waiting for the rain to pass away. And I'm looking for a brighter day. Rest upon your feet. Amen. Didn't we have some church this morning? Did Pastor preach this morning? Amen. He just blessed all of us. Amen. But thank God for this mighty man and this mighty woman of God. I thank God, amen, for what they mean in my life. You know, it's just good to have somebody that you can call. Now, I like for you to talk back to me. I say it's just good to have somebody that you can call. Not just anybody. I don't need just call anybody to touch and agree with me. Huh? I thank God that I have a friend. I have a brother. Amen. Notice I didn't even say a brother in the Lord. I have a brother. Amen. When people said, oh, you're my brother in the Lord, they're saying if it weren't for the Lord, you wouldn't be my brother. So we are sisters and we are brothers. We're in the same family, church. Shout glory. Father, touch our ears in order for us to hear what you have to say. We're here to say thank you for what you have already done. Thank you for the big plans that you have for your sons and your daughters. You get all the glory as we touch and agree on the same thing. And that's a word for my Lord. Get all the glory in this house in Jesus' name. Clap your hands and shout, yes. Now, the Lord go heal somebody. Say with me, Lord, start your healing with me. He gonna save somebody. Is somebody in the house? Start your saving, your salvation with me and my house. Now you can stand there and let me say all this good stuff and talk to the Lord. Tell the Lord, start your blessing with me. Start your deliverance with my house. Because he's gonna do some great things tonight. And I want him to start with me and my house. Are you going to speak for your house? Well, say it out. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. And it is so. Clap your hands and shout yes. Amen, amen, amen. You may take your seat. Take your Bible. I want you to go straightway with me to Philippians. Amen. The first chapter. I just want one verse. Shout one verse. Amen. I just want one verse here. Amen. The Lord spoke to me and he told me to tell you he didn't bring you this far to leave you. I know you heard it before, but you're going to hear it again tonight because God said, tell them they're not in this by themselves. I didn't bring them this far to walk off and leave. Shout glory. First chapter of Philippians, the sixth verse. Somebody shout glory. Amen. I'd like for you to read out loud with me. Amen. You could rest upon your feet as you do this. Amen. You're not going to be standing very long because it's one verse. Come on, somebody. That's some of your knees need healing anyhow. Amen. And those legs and hips and stuff. Come on. Amen, amen. Come on, God's got a word for the body. Shout glory. Can I ask you a question? You haven't thrown away your confidence, have you? The Bible said, cast not away your confidence, saith the Lord. Now, read with me out loud the sixth verse. Being confident of this very thing. Now, when you see this very thing, that's parting out one thing. Say one thing. Amen. Can you be confident in one thing? Not two, not three, but just one right now. Now, be in confidence of this very thing. Read it out loud right here. That he, say that again. That he, now this he is not just any he. This is a special he right here. This that he, read, which have begun a good work. What kind of work? He that have begun a what kind of work? A good work in who? It's in you. The work that he have begun is in you, and devil can't stop it. No matter what he throw your way, he can't stop what God has started in you. And I'm going to focus in on you knowing what's been invested in you. He that have begun a good work in who? In me. Come on, bring it home. In me. He begun this good work in me. Will what? Perform it. He will do what? Perform it until the day of the Jesus Christ. Clap your hands and shout yes. Come on, somebody. Shout yes. Oh, hallelujah. Look who's performing. You may take your seat. Who's performing on the stage in your life? Jesus, you just read, Jesus will perform the good work that he started in you. Not you. Jesus is doing the performance. What a performance. Nobody can outperform the one who's performing in the inside of the believers. Is there a church up in here? Amen. The Lord, listen, he wants you to know this one thing. Be sure he that started something. Now, I know you know somebody that started out with the Lord, and they are falling aside and doing their own thing. But if God ever started a work in them, don't give up on them. Don't throw in the towel on them. Because if God started that work in them, he going to catch up with them and finish what he started. When I was a little kid, God started a work in me. I was a guitar player in my dad's church. My sister got married Saturday and left Saturday. And in church, we looked, and there was nobody playing the piano. My dad said, Welton, go to the piano. I went to the piano. I never played the piano before. I played the guitar. He said, go to the piano, Welton. I went to the piano, and I just hauled off, started playing. He said, look at God. And God started a talent in me in church one Sunday night when my sister was gone. Daddy said, put the guitar down, play the piano. And my faith as a little kid just told me, go ahead, you could do it. And so I put my hands on the piano, and I began to play under the anointing of the Holy Ghost for that service that night. Been playing ever since. But I got detoured. How did I end up in a nightclub? God started a work in me when I was a little kid. How did I get there? How did I get detoured? Oh, that's a good question. But he started something. And guess what? It's not finished yet. He's still working on me. Please be patient with me. God's not through with me yet. Because when God get through, I shall come forth as pure gold. Somebody shout before I do. So God caught up with me in one nightclub one afternoon, one Saturday night. He walked in on me and he said, I need to finish what I started in you. I don't care where they're at. I don't care how deep in sin they have sunk. I just want you to know God has started a work in you. God has started a work in your son, in your daughter, in your friends. Come on, somebody. And you don't ever entertain their loss. No. They're not lost. They're on left field. But you can't forget there's a right field and a left field. God gonna draw them. God's gonna finish what he started in you. Can I get a witness up in here? Be in confidence of this one thing, that he that is performing on the stage of your life. Ooh, glory. What a performer. Jesus the Christ, the Son of the living God, is working on the inside of you. Little song says, Jesus on the inside, working on the outside, bringing about a change in me. Amen. He started something, and he's never known to start something and not finish it. How you know, preacher? Because he is an author, and he is the finisher of our now faith. And did he leave our faith undone, or did he perform it all the way? He started it, and he finished it, and he gave us a finished faith to operate in. Tell God thank you. Come on, tell him thank you. A good work. He's performing it until the day of Jesus the Christ. Woo, shout glory. What a performer. What a performer. And where he's performing, preacher, he's on the stage in your life. He's working on the inside of you. Where is that, preacher? He's in the inside. What he's doing, he's working on the inside. The work that he started in you, he's working on it. What are you doing, preacher? He's working it out for your good. He's working everything out for your good. That's what he's doing on the inside of you. That what was designed to take you out, brought you in. That what was designed to pull you down, push you up. Because of who's working on the inside of you. Sickness cannot destroy your body because a perfect and divine healer is working on the inside of you. Poverty can't destroy you because of who's working for you. Clap your hands and shout, yes, he's performing it, that good work. Look at Jesus, look at him. He's on the stage. Look at him. He's battling forces for you, beating back the forces of evil for you and your family. Call you in the house. He's working on our behalf because he loves us. Huh, what a performer. What a performer. Who else could reach down and pick up a man, a woman, in their sins and wash them in his own blood? Who else could do that? None other than this performer, the Jesus, the Christ, the Son of the living God. What a performer. He's performing for you. Wash him up, put clapping in his hand, running in his feet. Holy God, he's that kind of Savior. He's performing for you right now. While we're sleeping, while we're snoring, amen, he's still performing a good work. He never get an attitude with us. He always waits patiently upon us. He started and he gonna finish it. So I wonder, where's my support? Where's the arm to lean on? The Lord will remind you, I'm still here. You're going through a valley of despair. Glory, he's still working. Going through the valley of sickness and disease, he's still working. Perfect and divine health is on the inside of you. How could you be sick? Huh? What else working in here? Jesus is working. He's a performer. He said, I perform it and I finish it. Holy God, are you still in the house? Amen. He's working it out for your good. What? That's why the Bible says he's working all things out for your good. Where he's at, he's on your inside. Where's the greater you? On the inside. That's where you find Jesus. That's where you find your present help. He's on the inside working all things out for your good. Don't try to fight your own battle. Let Jesus do it for you. He said nobody could get even like I can. He said when you touch my anointing, you touch me. Oh, come on. Amen. See, God said, let me work it. Don't you try to work it. I'm on your stage. I'm on the stage. I'm standing up here for you on your behalf. I'm up here, and I'm looking out over your enemy. And I'm here to tell you, you have no successful enemies because of who's on the stage of your life. You're standing. You feel like you're standing alone. But you're not alone. He's standing up for you. Even when you're down, he's standing up for you, saying, I'm on the stage. I'm performing that good work that I started on the inside of you. Jesus on the inside, working on the outside, bringing about a change in me, in you. Come on, somebody. He outperformed good. He outperformed evil. Huh? Remember when the young man came to him and said, good master. Jesus looked up at him and said, don't call me that. He said, only one good, and that's my father. Are you in the house? Listen, now the young man looked at him, and the only thing, Jesus was the only one doing good. And he just addressed him, good master. He said, the one that's good is my father. Are you in this house, somebody? The good master, amen, he's working for your good. Shout for my good. This performer did not have any lesson. He didn't have no license to practice medicine. But no doctor ever outperformed him on a patient. The blind man doctor, I'm sure he did all that he could for this blind man. But he still couldn't see, sister. He still was blind. But Jesus the Christ, the Son of the living God, he outperformed every doctor in the day. Nobody outperformed him. Oh, you still hear somebody? Amen, amen. Tell God thank you. Tell God thank you. No wonder, no wonder. Amen. A lot of people couldn't stand him. That's why they talk bad about him, trying to damage his reputation, but it spoke for itself. Nobody could do what he did. He never practiced nothing, but he mastered everything. He never practiced walking on the water. He didn't say, no, he didn't practice. He didn't even question that's water in this land. He was walking on the land and kept a walk. He didn't practice walking on the water. He just walked in the face of the deep. Walked in the water's face. He's a performer like no other. And he's performing in you. He's in you. Can you hear that? He's on the inside of you doing what you cannot do. Is he still on the inside? What are you doing, preacher? Let me get a little closer to him, and I'll tell you what he's doing. He's performing a miracle. What he's doing, he's putting a smile on a face that a frown have been on the face so long, the frown have cut its way into the face. And he's putting a smile on a man's face who never smile. What are you doing now, preacher? He's putting joy where sorrow and sadness was. What he's doing now, he's performing where he's put love where hate used to take over. He's a performer. He can do, what is he doing? He could do what we cannot do. I need somebody like that. I need somebody who can go farther than I could go. I need somebody to reach me when I can't reach them. What a performer on the stage in your life.
beaten by demon forces away from you and your house, when you don't feel like praying, and when you're tired of praying, he's up there right now performing prayer meeting for you and my house. He's praying for us now, not just little prayer, but it's the kind of prayer that your gut get involved in. Intercessory prayer, when your the blood start running in your veins, speeding up when you're showing up praying, an intercessory prayer. It actually tighten up the muscles in your body, and you feel what you're saying. You're connecting to the heavens. Intercessory prayer is a shown up prayer. It's praying where you don't know nobody around you. Praying till you forgot who you are. Praying knowing that heaven is open to every request that you made known to him. This prayer warrior, he's performing a prayer meeting in heaven right now. It's called intercessory prayer. You know what he's saying? I saved her. I started a work in her, but she walked away from me. But I'm drawing her because I didn't finish what I started in her. Did you hear that? He's drawing him. Stop praying, save my son, Lord, and start praying, draw my son, Lord. He can't come to him unless he draw him. The Lord said that himself. He said, no one could come to the Father unless he's been drawn. Are you still in the house? Are you still with me? He did not need to practice medicine. He did not need a lab. He did not need research. He carried enough medicine in the hem of his garment to not just heal that little woman. Everybody that was sick could have touched the same garment, but they stood there sick in their body and didn't even reach out and try to touch him. I would have been running up on him myself. I would have been bumping up against him myself. I would have been reaching for him myself. They saw that woman be healed for reaching out, touching just the hem of his garment. Amen. But they sat there and said, oh, wasn't that wonderful? Touching Jesus. That's all that matters. Come on, somebody. And your life will never be the same. He was the greatest doctor in the world. He know nobody can fish like him. A couple of fishers out there coming in, bringing their nets, and getting cleaned up, knocking off for the evening. Jesus, hey, guys. He said, yeah. So how much fish you catch? How long you been out there? Well, we've been out there all night long, man. And we haven't caught nothing. He said, hey, see that area right over there that you just passed? Yeah. Just get your nets. I see you didn't fold them, but just get your net and go back out there and cast that net on the other side. And nobody fish like that. Nobody know where to pinpoint the fish and know where the fish at. I believe he was looking through the water, seeing the fish, saying, here I am, tell him, okay, here we're waiting on him. God said, here I am to us, here I am, I'm waiting on you to believe of the word that I have already written on the tablet pages of your heart. It's already in you. He's performing. He's performing that good work. Oh, what a performer. Somebody shout, and it is so. Amen. Nobody could outperform our Jesus, the one that's working in you. His name was Lazarus. The performer was in a crusade somewhere. They called for him. Come quick. The one that you love is sick. He got there 4 days late. Mary met him with an attitude. Why you show up now, Jesus? My brother dead and buried and stinking, Jesus. Why are you here? Mary, I'm here. I know you're here, Jesus, but my brother is dead. He ain't here. Mary, do you know who I am, Mary? Yeah, I know who you are. I know you didn't show up. But Mary, I'm the resurrection. All this time, you really don't know who I am, girl. I'm the resurrection and the life. Jesus said, hey, Mary, Martha said, well, I'll tell you what. I know I'll see my brother again in the great resurrection 1,000 years from now. Jesus said, come, come here. Now show me. Why he asked her to show? He knew there was one graveyard in town. Show me where you buried him. Mary, here he is. He's getting ready to perform on the stage. Everybody looking. Where he at? There he is, the great performer. He's getting ready to do something. First, he's calling. He's calling. Who he's calling? Lazarus? What a performer. But, oh, wait a minute. He needs somebody to participate in this part of his performance. And he's going to call somebody to work with him in this performance. He said, Lazarus, hey, come here, Lazarus. And they heard a ruckus. And they heard a sound coming out of the hole in the ground. And they were looking. And all of a sudden, they focus in on this great performer. And they look real close at him. And they look at him as big tears began to run down the performer's eyes. He looked at the people who didn't believe. He looked at the people who didn't think he could do anything. But after a while, here come the other half. Lathers began to hop. Come here. Hey, babe. I want you, to can you go up these steps? No. Now keep like this. Don't bend your knees now. Huh? You can't jump without bending your knees. You don't, okay. Jump without bending your knees. Where's your faith, girl? She couldn't do it. Lather was wrapped up. His legs was wrapped up. Came up some steps. He caught the spirit that drawed. Had to draw Lathers out of there because you couldn't come up out of a hole in the ground. All tied up. What did Jesus say? Loose him and let him go. But he was, he was moving without moving. This performer is performing in you tonight. Victory is performing in the inside of you. How could you not have victory in your life? Think of it. He can do anything but fail, and he's on the inside of you and me. The That's why he wants us to yield our entire body to him. And when we do that, he's on the inside working, but he'll take off from the working on the inside of you to do what you say do. He'll touch through your hands. He'll heal through your hands. When you say, I'm yielded to this vessel that's working for me, he's working for me. So in the name of Jesus, healer that's on the inside, perform on the outside. Bring about a change in my family. Shout glory. Shout it out, glory. There's a lot of stages, a lot of acting, but Jesus never act. He did. It was I that touched you. And when I touched you, it was I who turned and tried to run away from you. When she touched him, the Savior didn't see. But he turned around and said, somebody touch me. Listen, believers. When you realize who's on the inside of you, you can easily touch Jesus. And see, there's a difference in touches. See, you can touch him. And you could touch him and pull what you need out of him. Are you listening? When I prayed for my wife, when we took her to the hospital for her back, and the doctor said, I said, what? Doctor, well, can you do something for her back? It was just breaking me in two seeing her suffer with her back. He said, no, that's not important right now. I said, what you mean this is not important right now, doctor? That's why we're here. He said, no, I've got something more serious going on. See, I had no idea that my wife had pneumonia and septic. What is it? Did I say it right? Septic. Except what? I really don't want to say it. She had sepsis. The doctor said she could have left here. Because we just thought her back. She was bothered with her back. We had no idea she had pneumonia and sepsis. And that disease is what took Muhammad Cassius Clay out of here. That's what he died of. Patty Duke, that's what she died of. And several people, I mean, right when she had it, people were dying on the news with it. See, weapons that's formed against you will not prosper because of who's working on the inside of you. We had no idea. We were ignorant to the fact. But Jesus brought it to our attention. Oh, come on, somebody. See, when you know he's on the inside, working on the outside of you. See, the Jesus that's taking care of your inward parts, your spirit man, he also take care of your outer affairs and your outer stuff that concern you're concerned with. He's concerned. Yes, he is. In your life, your stage, you're just sitting there watching him do what you're supposed to be doing. He said, hey, you sit there while I make your enemy your footstool. Don't you try to do it. Let me do it. They think they're getting over on you. They're not getting over on you. Their tongue is touching my anointed vessels. And I will put a stop to that fiery tongue that's in them that's touching on my vessels. Somebody better hush. Hush up. That's the way my grandma used to say. When she said, hush up, You can hear a pin drop. People outside hush. See, don't dig your grave with your tongue. Touch not my anointed vessels. Somebody need to repent. Touch not my vessels of honor. God said, when you touch him, you're touching me. Uzzah reached out and touched the Ark of the Covenant when it kind of, the stumbled guy stumbled. And God said, touch not my anointed. The Ark of the Covenant was untouchable. He reached out and called himself. He was doing a good deed. He said, I'm not keeping it from falling over. And Uzzah looked like he was hit with a Uzzur after he touched God's anointing. That was a word for somebody. Thank God for it. You know, we got a saying, practice make what? But he never practiced. And he was perfection. Practice make perfect. I never practice. Maybe I should. Yeah, won't hurt. But whatever he do for you is good. Would you rest upon your feet? Songwriter said, whatever, everything he do for me is good. Yes, it is. Jesus, the performer, nobody bypassed him in nothing. Are you in the house? Holy God, thank you, Jesus. Jesus, he said, he will finish what he started in you. He never left anything unfinished. What did he declare to his Father as he hung between heaven and earth? Father, it's finished. Paul, what did he say? He said, I run a race that was set before me. He said, I fought a good fight. I kept the faith. What he was doing? He was walking the last mile of the way. He was on his way to Nero chopping block that was going to separate his head from his shoulders. But did you hear him crying and complaining? He said, I fought a good fight. I'm ready now. What was it? He too had a performing on his stage. God said, all of us, he done started something. All of us, he have started something. And I declare it's good. Thank you, Jesus. You know, things that you don't know, he'll tell you what to do. And the information that you don't know, when you obey him, like take her to the hospital. That was news there waiting on me, that the devil was trying to destroy my wife. 52 years of marriage. Over 132 children we raised. Trying to sneak in, but God stopped it. God blocked it. He wouldn't let it be. Come on, because he started a good work in my wife, and he had not finished it yet. Are you in here tonight and said, I know God started something in me? and I want him to finish. I want to get out of his way and let him have his way. I want to move back and let him move closer to me. Holy God. And preacher, I need to draw close to him, because he said in his word, if you draw close to me, I draw close to you. We have a tendency that the Lord is the only one drawing close. And No. He said, if you draw close, I'll draw close. He don't push himself on nobody. That's why he said, whosoever will, let him come. Because everybody that start with you, not going in with you. I just want to do God's will. And I just want his will to be done in my life. I know he has started something in my life. How many here raise your hand and say, I want him to finish what he started in my life? Come on, somebody. And it's in God's time. Just, if you will, would you just come stand up here? Just across the front here. I just want to pray for you, that's all. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, you start. Lord, I know you call me to do a work for you. I want your will to be done. I want your will to be done. I want your will to be done in my life. Say that. I want your will to be done. Say, I want your will to be done. I want your will to be done in my life. Finish the work that you started, Lord. Finish the work that you started, Lord. Finish the work that you started, Lord. Finish the work that you started. Let your will be done. Sing. Let your will be done. 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 Oh Lord, let your will be done. Let your will be done. Finish the work, Lord. Oh God, finish the work, Lord. Finish the work, Lord. Oh Lord, finish the work, Lord. Let your will be done. There's a healing touch taking place in the lower part of your belly. Hallelujah. Let your will be done. Let your will be done, Lord. Finish the work that you started. 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 Finish the work, Lord, that you started. Finish the work that you started. Finish the work that you started.
Finish the work that you started. Finish the work that you started. Everybody say, finish the work that you started. Finish the work that you started. Finish the work that you started, Lord Jesus. Finish the work that you started in me. 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 Finish the work that you started. Finish the work that you started. Finish the work that you started. Finish the work that you started in me. Let your will be done. Say, let your will be done. Everybody sing, let your will be done, Lord Jesus. Let your precious will be done. Let your will be done, Lord, yeah. Let your will be done, Lord Jesus. Let your will be done, Lord. Every day let your will be done. Finish the work that you started. 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 Oh, start in me, Lord. Lord Jesus, start in me, Lord. Come on and start in me. Every day, Lord, start in me. Let your will be done, Lord. Let your will be done, Lord. Everybody, let your will be done, Lord. Let your will be done in me. Finish the work that you started in me. Finish the work that you started in me. Finish the work. Oh, 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 Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Let your will be done. Let your will be done. Take your hands off, little sister, and let the Lord put his hands on. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Finish the work that you started in me. 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 Finish the work. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, Holy One, Holy One. Let your will be done, Lord. Let your will be done, Lord. Let your will be done, Lord. Let your will be done. Oh, let your will be done, Lord. And let your will be done. Yeah. Finish the work, Lord. Cover the little ones, Father. Holy God, somebody give God some praise. Did I miss anybody? Did I miss anybody? I miss somebody. Come on, give God some praise. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, finish the work. Finish the work, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Holy God. God. Hallelujah. God bless you, my brother. Holy God, holy God. Finish the work. Let the healing virtue run through the veins, Lord. Finish. Oh, thank you. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 It's getting better. The load is real heavy. God said he's lighting that load. He's working on the inside. You're going to see a change in your life, in your body, in your surroundings. Change is taking place. Somebody shout glory. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Father, for your glory. For your glory. You get the glory out of this young lady in Jesus' name. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. Would you bless the Lord? Would you help us? I know you will. Those of you that said, Brother Lane, I can invest $20 in this camp meeting. Shout, yes, I can. Okay, put some legs on that, yes, I can, and come get the $20. I want to take mine. Every time somebody obey God, clap your hands. Every time they dunk the basketball, they hoop and they holler. Everybody obeying God, you need to praise God in the house. Woo, thank you, Jesus. God bless you, little sister. God bless you, my brother. Somebody, come on, come on, come on. I don't want to. God bless you, my brother. God bless. And whatever you could give, if you could give more than 20, don't hesitate. Just do it. I want whatever you have to give. Would you come, please? Praise God. This camp meeting, you hear pastors say it all the time, it's not about money. But you could look around about you and tell it really is about us giving. Oh, come on, don't get quiet on me now. Come on. We need to rally together and help support these men of God and pastors. God bless you. God bless you. Whatever you have to give, would you come and give whatever you have to give tonight? Praise God. Amen. God said, I'll beautify the meek with salvation. Amen. Come, would you?